Hello guys, today we're going to look at the CV joint on the Wanagon. Porsche is also using the same, so it's applicable to the Porsche as well. So I will show you how this works. As a reference for this building of this joint, I have used this axle I got from Brickworks. And if you look at the details on this one, you can see that there's a groove slit that's pointing against the gearbox. And we can also see that this side that goes to the gearbox is completely flat. As I will show you on this one. One flat side and one thrust washer side. Easy to see in real life anyway. So, I was hoping this was correctly built because I have seen a lot of CV joint built different way on the YouTube and on the internet. So, when I take a closer look at this Brickworks shaft, I see that this one has a comfort edge, and the other side has a flat non-comfort edge, which I will say this one is correct and this one is wrong built. Comfort edge should be against the axle. I will show you on this one. This slit, whatever this is called in English, is going to the gearbox. This one without the slit or a mark, it's going to the axle or the wheel. This piece has an thrust surface. It's an extra thing that is cast on it. This one is completely flat to the gearbox. This is not, does not have a comfort edge. This one has. And the reason for that is when the joint is in the maximum position and the axle is going like this, it's not supposed to grind on the metal here. That's why it's comfort. So let's disassemble this and see how we are building them. It's just a matter of twist it and push until you get one ball free. And there you go. And then you can have it taken out. This is supposed to come out like this. If you take a closer look at this, you can see this extra metal on this edge. On this side, it is completely flat. Flat against the gearbox. This piece, which is a thrust surface, goes toward the axle and the wheel. This one has also this comfort edge on one side. On the other side, it is flat. Flat against the gearbox, comfort edge to the wheel. So then, put it together, thrust washer to the wheel, comfort edge to the wheel, putting it inside and just twisting it. Putting the balls in place. You can also do that afterwards. And then this one to the gearbox, this one to the wheel. Again, thrust surface to the wheel. And here's one important thing. You see they have a narrow and a wide. The narrow goes against the wide. Wide goes against narrow every other time. If not, you will end up with a very stiff, you cannot move it at all. So, let's see if we can make this one fit. Here we go. You have to work it all the time. Constantly make it slide up and down. Here we go. Last one. And here we go. Down again. Slit, gearbox, camfer edge, wheel, thrust surface against the axle and the wheel. Flat gearbox, flat to the gearbox. That's it really. That it's supposed to be built. And when you have this narrow against the wide, wide against narrow, you can push the lead like this. It will be smooth. Oh, hi. What the hell? And there we have it. It's not that hard, as long as you know what you're doing. So pay attention to all the small details and you will be good to go. Okay, this one is now very flexible. It's a little hard to show it on the camera, but it's going out and in without any problem at all. Yeah. If you have any questions, please put them down below and I will try to answer them as good as I can. Okay, that's all. Thanks for watching, guys. See you around. Bye.